So we've just come from the airport. We're in Bali, we're in Sanur now, and we're waiting for our boat to start boarding. We're with Artemis Ferries. We've just seen the boat. We're waiting for 4 o'clock now to get on the fast boat over to Nusa Lembongan. Okay, see you later. One of the reasons I'm looking so hot and sweaty right now, apart from this is Indonesia and I'm always hot and sweaty, is they've moved the ferry terminal. And whereas it was just a shack on the beach, now they've got a professional kind of cow shed set up for them with all the ferries in a row. So I guess that's a huge improvement. The only problem is, as you can see behind me, is you used to be able to sit on the beach and wait. Now you kind of got to sit in the cattle shed. Anyway, I'll give you a quick spin behind me. That's kind of what I'm talking about. It's good that they're all together in one area now. I just wish I'd known that before I arranged the taxi to drop me right at the door of where it used to be. Got out with all the dive equipment and then had to lug the dive equipment about 200 meters down the road. Oh well. Okay, hopefully I'll be on the boat next time you see me. Fingers crossed.
Take them anyway.
got Nusa Lembongan. Now the dive sites on Nusa Lembongan itself, we've got three. We've got Lembongan Bay, we've got Blue Corner, and we've got Mangrove. So Mangrove, if you do it right, and there's coral reef somewhere out here, and you start on that coral reef and catch a drift in, is a five-star dive site. The coral reef is immaculate. If you've never seen an immaculate coral reef before, you need to dive out here and come in through Mangroves. The fish life is, it's packed. There is so much fish life on that reef, it's unbelievable. And I've dived a lot in my time, and I would say this is an example of an immaculate reef. Okay. Most people though, I do point out, if you dive that and go, I didn't see anything, then you've probably dived in too close here and you've not done the reef, which stretches out somewhere out here into the channel. You really have to start out into the channel and come in. Blue Corner, another good dive site. Blue Corner, I've dived with dolphins, baby dolphins at Blue Corner. That drift can get really fast round the corner there. So only really for more experienced divers. And then we've got Nusa Lembongan Bay, which is mainly for training dives, but just recently, due to the pandemic and boats being neglected, there are a number of new wrecks dropped down there. And so good little wreck dives, but nothing on the scale of the Liberty over in Tulumben. So super safe, usually training, and these two super drifts, but with Mangroves, get right out here almost into the channel where the coral reef starts, immaculate reef, and brings you back into Nusa Lembongan. And so those are the three main dive sites here on Lembongan.
Baggy, Roy. Thank you.
I guess he's unloading the boat.
Okay.
let's look at the northern sites. As you can see, we've got Nusa Penida here, and at the north of Nusa Penida, we've got six sites. So they start at 4, which is SD, then you've got Puraped, then you've got Sental, then you've got Puramaskading, you've got Bayuk, and you've got Sampalan. And so it's one stretch of wall, sloping coral, and it's just divided into dives. So each dive takes about an hour in length, and they kind of overlap. The topography is, it starts in shallow and then rolls down in a slope to very deep, and the fish life is abundant, particularly around SD, around this area here, that you'd see lots and lots of fish on your dive, generally speaking, with a really good current. Also along here, there have been sightings of whale sharks and mola mola, because it comes up from deep. So this trip, we'll be diving a number of northern sites. We probably won't do them all. I have done them all in my time, but the topography is very, very similar. It's a slope that starts shallow and then runs all the way down to the really, to depth, with lots and lots of coral, lots and lots of fish life. Okay, that's the northern dive sites.
The coldness, the coldness, the coldness, the coldness, the coldness. So Roy's on this side, to come down this side, so it's easy for him to come here. Thank you.
Thank you.
Condolence.
The southern sites of Nusa Penida are Manta Bay and Manta Point. both are manta cleaning stations. Both are very popular with mantas. And generally speaking, if you don't have mantas up at Manta Bay, you probably will get mantas down at Manta Point and vice versa. Having dived here a number of times, it's unlikely that you don't see a manta. So nothing's guaranteed in scuba diving, but there are usually handfuls of mantas on these manta cleaning stations. Both dive sites are quite shallow, and definitely Manta Point can be snorkeled from above. Also at Manta Point, there's quite a lot of bamboo sharks, and it's quite rare not to see a bamboo shark whilst at Manta Point waiting for the mantas. And even if you don't sit at the cleaning station, even if you dive around the area, chances are you will bump into a manta at some point. Okay.
That bit's only going to be 20 meters, so you can go.
Please, we have the giant ocean in Manta, and we have the reef mantrae. But the most commonly found there are the reef mantrae, and we have the...
Mm-hmm.
four dive sites in the Ceningan Channel. They start up here at Toyapakeh, and then you go down to, where are we, Ceningan Wall, on the other side. We've got 16 with Gamet's Bay, then this will be Crystal Bay. Generally, the current can be really strong through the channel, and this part of the channel here between Ceningan and Nusa Penida is super deep. Crystal Bay probably being the more famous site for boats grabbing lunch. It's a nice sheltered bay, but it's probably more famous for the sunfish, the molar. It's a really good place to get out onto the coral wall in the channel and start looking for banner fish, start going down deep and looking for the molar. Okay, probably my most dive spot is Crystal Bay, and that's because it's always a favourite stop after you've visited the southern sites and seen the mantas. Okay, so that'll be Ceningan Passage dive sites.
No, I never do it, it always comes off and it ends up being a disaster on video.
Okay?
Okay.
Thank you.